What's up, everyone? Welcome back to my channel. Now today, we are gonna do a battle of the Mattallic liquid lipsticks. Now, I'm sure a lot of you saw the title and you were like, ooh, bitch, you gonna try it. Before we jump into all this, first of all, we are gonna do a test of the Mattallic lips. So today, what do I have? I have the new ColourPop 4 little bundle. This comes with 4 shades. They are all metallic. Ooh, there's a little sneak peek. And then I also picked up 2 of the new Kylie metals. Now this one is KyMajesty and this one is Heir, H-E-I-R. And we got some Milani, which I have tried one of these before, so I got a bunch of colors and I wanted to see how they compare to some of the other brands. Before we dive into all the swatches and comparisons and all the information, I am gonna start out with a little backstory. I know a lot of you are gonna see the Kylie stuff and be like, ooh, girl. Let me just spill the tea really quickly and just dive into it. About a month ago, I'm sure as most of you have seen, I went on Snapchat and I did a little unboxing and I got the Kylie glosses, not the liquid lips. Disclaimer, in case you really don't know the full story, I tried the lip glosses live on Snapchat and the wands were really fucked up. Like when I pulled it out, it was like, king. It looked like my dog had chewed on it and put it back and didn't tell me. I was very freaked out about it on Snapchat and I ended up throwing them in the trash. Now, this video is not a bashing video. There is no bullying going on. This is just the honest truth and my opinion and my facts. So, going back to the Snapchat incident, I did throw them away and I was really offended that the wands were so bad because I had high expectations from Kylie. When I went on Twitter, I was kind of venting about it and all of a sudden, thousands of girls started tweeting me pictures of their wands. Now, I had no idea that Kylie kind of addressed this on her Snapchat, but it was just put to rest. No one got any new wands, no one was getting refunds, customer service was just ignoring everyone. Now, this was from a lot of customers on Twitter telling me this. This is not just me making this up out of thin air. This is an actual fact, and it had been about 18 days since people got all the defective wands, and they had heard silence. So I did open up my big mouth, and I'm really glad I did it because so many people finally got new wands and the issue was addressed. But prior to me making a big fuss about it, no one had heard anything about it. So I feel like no matter what anyone wants to say about me or judge me about it for judging her brand, I did it because I am a consumer. And I think at the end of the day, people forget just because I am somebody that is well known and I have my own cosmetic brand, pretend none of that shit exists. At heart, I am a consumer. I am a makeup artist since I was 12 years old. I am a makeup lover, and this is my entire passion in my career. So obviously, I had no idea that it would be such big news. All of a sudden, the next morning, I wake up and it's like Cosmo Magazine, 17, and InStyle, and Daily Mail, and all these news sites started writing about makeup artist Jeffree Star attacks Kylie, and I'm just like, I didn't attack anyone, I was just giving my honest opinions. And that's just what it is, it was honest, and if people were offended that I judged her brand, I'm sorry, the wands were shitty, they really were. And finally, they acknowledged it after I gave it so much attention. So if I were to never speak up about it, would anyone get refunds? Would anyone get new ones? I don't know, that's up to you guys to, you know, obviously determine that. I think the big stink of it at the end of the day was another incident, which most people have seen or heard about this drama, is me judging Kylie's brand, and then a month later, I put out highlighters, and there was this kid on YouTube, who a lot of you have seen this video, and he received a broken highlighter. Now, let's start from that fucking whole beginning, because that got really crazy and really ugly very quickly, and I don't think people know the full story. Before my Skin Frost highlighters were ever on sale on my website, before they ever shipped out into the world, I sold them at a convention called RuPaul's Drag Con. Now there was about almost 20,000 people at that convention. I debuted the product there in hand, so there was no shipping involved, and a few people got broken ones, which I did not know at the time that they were already broken when we sold them. So let me just do a little backtrack. I wanna give a little backstory on manufacturing. All 4 shades were made separate. So when they did ice cold, they made all the ice cold at the same time. Then move on to King Tut. We did 100,000 right off the bat to start of King Tut. Now I was unaware when they were traveling, meaning when they were picked up from a third party truck, It's a delivery truck that comes and they make it from the factory and then they drive it to my warehouse where we of course ship it out to all of you guys. I was unaware that one of the forklifts had dropped about 3,000 to 4,000 King Tuts on the fucking concrete, like BAM! And they were shattered. It was horrifying. Now, the worst part about it is we were all unaware until they started to ship out weeks after the DragCon incident. Enter Rocky Road Kill, who at DragCon got a broken highlighter. Now, a lot of people were tweeting me, ooh, this kid's talking shit about you. He's like doing a clickbait video. You really gotta check it out. And I was like, what the hell? Like, are people really coming for me? Like, I honestly was like, oh God. And you know what? It had been a really long day. I logged in to YouTube, clicked in, I saw the title, and the first 5 seconds of the video was like him crying or something. And I was like, what the fuck is going on? So, my dumbass did not fully watch the video, which I 100% admit, and that was probably my biggest mistake. So instead of fully watching the video and understanding what happened, I went on his comment section and I was like, look, bitch, you're out of your motherfucking mind. So I went off for a second and wrote a comment. Now, that situation was put to rest. I felt like people wanted me to make a whole video dedicated to it, and it's like, I don't need to address every comment that I leave somebody, and I think it just got really ugly and out of hand. In case you were unaware, I did write back to his second video, and after a while, people were leaving death threats and really ugly comments and just being so ugly. I actually removed the comment and just screenshotted it, and I DM'd him directly. But in case you were not aware, let me read it verbatim. I said, hey boo, now that things have calmed down, I'd love to personally send you a message and apologize for the comment I made on your previous video. That day, I had so many people tweeting me and filling my head with lies, saying that you made a video degrading me. The title of the video was definitely something that shocked me, and I should have known better and watched the entire thing myself. I regret judging you before writing anything. At the time of DragCon, I was not aware of the incident. When they were delivered to my warehouse, all the colors were in separate boxes. Everything seemed perfect. I had no idea that some of the King Tuts were broken previous to me getting them in my hands. So, after we shipped them, I was horrified and heartbroken as a brand owner that so many people experienced the broken highlighter. And, you know, out of the hundreds of thousands that sold that week, there was 3,000 that were bad, and it's still 3,000 customers that got a shitty experience, and for that, I am forever sorry, and it just sucks. So, I said, you know, now that I've addressed the issue, and now I know the real reason for what happened to your highlighter, I know that you no longer support me, 100% respect that, did not think that he should respect me after the incident, but I just wanted to clear the air so everyone knows the truth about what really went down. Now that we are past that, I think it's time to start this review. So I guess basically I wanted to give a little history because this review is not coming from a negative place. Whether these lipsticks are great or not, you guys are gonna have to continue and see what happens. So if you want to see me swatch ColourPop, Kylie, and Milani, keep on watching. Alright, so let's dive into it. The first brand that we're gonna try out is ColourPop. Now, they recently just launched 4 shades, new metallic formula, and bam, let's open up this guy. On their website, it says metals, just like the Kylie ones. This was the PR package it came in. There are 4 shades. Let's see here. We got Maneater, very cute bronzy one. And then we got Three-way, okay girl, I see you. That's like a more raspberry metallic. And then we got another more copper shade. This one is called Queen, K-W-E-E-N, okay girl. And then the fourth one is a more deep bronze color and that is called Zebra. So I'm just gonna try 2 shades out of all the brands so my mouth does not fall off. And I think I'm gonna pick this copper one and then this, maybe the darker one. Now, these are liquid lipsticks, but on their site it says this is a super intense metallized liquid lipstick that is dripping with high impact metallic pearls. This is a non-drying formula, so it is not supposed to dry all the way down, so that should be a quick disclaimer. It does not dry all the way down and it is not transfer proof, meaning it will come off if you eat or drink, I think. But it says, this formula was created to be luxurious, smooth, and leave a super comfortable feel on the lips. While the formula is not completely transfer resistant, it is extremely long wearing. All right. So I'm gonna try Maneater first. All right, so let's get into this. This is kind of like a little first impressions for every brand since I have not tried these. Now this applicator is very cute and little. You can see it there. They don't really smell bad at all. Now my sinuses are a little clogged from this crazy allergy season of summer, but not bad at all. Let's give it a whirl. Okay, so right off the bat, this is very lightweight. It almost feels a little dry. Not like it's drying up my mouth to death, but it just feels like it's a little dry. It could be from the pearls in the pigment. Okay, so right off the bat, let me zoom in on myself. The coverage is really nice, actually. There's a tiny bit of transfer, not bad at all. Not sticky at all, which I love, because I hate when you like put your lips together and your lips are like, they're like holding on for dear life, like,
baby moisture, bitch.
This is really good. I'm like, okay, ColourPop, I see you. Okay, so let me quickly wipe this off, and then we're gonna try three-way. Now, this color is so pretty. It's three-way. It is a like metallic berry color, really pretty, and let's see what happens. Right off the bat, I can already tell that this one is a little less pigmented. It just seems a little more sheer to me already just from putting on the first application. This one has a lot of glitter in it, which I think is so pretty. You definitely gotta dip in several times more than the first shade. Okay, let's let this dry. Did I just get lipstick in my hair? Okay, thank God. So when I put two coats of this on, it was a way more full coverage. So I think the copper one before it was a little bit more pigmented, but when you layer it, it doesn't get weird, which if you guys are a liquid lipstick lover, sometimes if you layer, the liquid lipstick can get gummy, it cracks, or it just doesn't settle correctly, but this layered actually really great. So I had no issues putting on a second coat. This one is really pretty. Still that same moisturized effect, it's not drying or anything. So, okay, ColourPop, I see you. Now, for $6, you really cannot go wrong with these, so I am a fan of these. Now, let's get on to Kylie's. Right, now, the next brand I'm gonna try is Kylie Cosmetics. She recently put out Metals, which are her metallic formula, and I have KyMajesty and Heir. Now, I heard a lot of controversy about this shade, so I got it in the mail about a week ago. I have not tried it yet. First of all, I know a lot of people have been reviewing them, and there's one review that has over a million views, and people are going crazy about it, so I'm like, okay, I have the shade too, let me give it a whirl. Quick disclaimer, a lot of these are sold out right now, and these retail for $18 a piece. I'm gonna be Jeffrey, of course, and pick the dark metallic one first. I'm totally drawn to weird colors of lipsticks. Is black weird anymore? I don't think so. This comes in a similar packaging of ColourPop. I mean, this is kind of bizarre to me. I always thought these are identical components. But of course, all of the rumors that they are made at the same factory, I don't fucking know, I don't care. But ColourPop's is sickening, so let's give this one a whirl. Now, the ColourPop wand was a little more fatter. This one, as you can see, is a little thinner. It looks kind of more flat. Now to me, these smell really intense. I wish they would just tone it down a tiny bit. It is a little more streaky. Now I am layering it again, and it is helping. So maybe like the ColourPop, it does need two layers. Let me dip in again. The wand on the ColourPop one was a little more easier to use. This one feels very like, it feels really light for some reason. The ColourPop ones are a little more heavy. Going back over it a second time. It does feel moisturizing like the ColourPop one. It's not tacky, it's not sticky. It does give a little more of like a weird film on your lips, but it's not bad. It feels very hydrating, which is amazing because no one wants dry ass lips. Now, I am just gonna touch up a little bit because as you can see, if you zoom in, it is just kind of patchy and streaky a little bit. So I'm gonna put a tiny bit more. Now, this wand is very kind of flat and stiff. Maybe the pearls did not love the material because that has happened to me before. All right, this is dried down now. I love the color. I think this metallic black is very innovative. No one has really done this before. The formula, I think, could be a little bit more opaque, but coming from someone that also makes liquid lipsticks, it is very hard to get a metallic to be really opaque and still give that beautiful shine. Now that we've tried this one, let's do the second one, which is called Heir. All right, now this shade, ooh, this looks really pretty. This is like a champagne nude with like gold reflex in it. Let's give it a whirl. Now, this wand already looks way better than the black one and still has that really strong like licorice scent as the other one. All right, let's try it. Okay, this definitely has a different texture than KyMajesty. This one is more kind of like moussey, and it's a little streaky, but the coverage is still nice. I just kind of had to finesse it with the wand. And only thing is it's not really giving me like metallic. There's like a little bit of sheen in it, but the black one was like blinging, and like the ColourPop ones were like really glittery and metallic. This one is a little more subdued. All right, let's let this dry down. First impressions is I actually like this formula way more than KyMajesty. This one just kind of blended a lot more easier, and even though it's not as metallicized, I like it. It gives a pretty little sheen to the lips, very natural. So if you're afraid of the other unconventional colors, I think this one would definitely suit you. And it feels really soft, creamy, and nice when I smile. Not really any cracking at all. It looks really cute. So I think definitely out of the two, I like this one better. All right, now the third brand that I'm gonna try is the new Milani Amore Mattallics. These are so pretty. Now, a few weeks ago, I tried this in my Summer Glow makeup tutorial, and I was like,
damn, these are really cute.
But I want to see if the other shades match, because sometimes brands do not have consistency in their formulas. So sometimes one will be amazing, and then another shade will be kind of eh. So I'm like, okay, this one is cute. We've tested her, so I found four more. Now, these are $8.99, so they are a little bit more affordable than the Kylie ones, but a little higher than ColourPop. These are a limited edition, and on the Milani website, it says that these are bold and richly pigmented. These metallic liquid lip colors shine with a soft luster and dry to a smooth matte finish without drying out your lips. Waterproof and kiss approved, each Amore metallic lip cream delivers up to 16 hours of wear.
God damn.
Remove with an oil-based long wear lip color remover. Okay, cool. So these are supposed to dry down and stay for a minute. I'm like, okay, girl, I see you. So I'm gonna try out, let's see. You guys know I wanna do the pink, so let me just pluck these out. Sorry, girls. I'll see you on the next one. So I'm gonna do this one called Cinematic. It is kind of like a fuchsia metallic pink. I mean, hi, right up my alley. So let's give her a spin. Now, this one looks so pretty in the bottle. I'm like, don't do me wrong. Oh, wow. See, right off the bat, full coverage. Come on, Milani. So my videographer can smell the lip paint fragrance all the way from back there. It is very, very strong. It's like, ooh, girl, I better tone it down. Now, obviously, we talked about it before, but a lot of brands use really strong fragrances to mask the raw material ingredients. So this one is definitely like, whew, like slaps you in the face. Now that was just with one swipe. I'm gonna dip in to finish the last part of my lip, but that was a lot of coverage for just dipping in once. All right, bam. Now this color is gorgeous. I am really like, ooh, I'm like amazed. This has been sitting in my drawer for a few weeks now. I've been waiting to get some other shades to review them all at once. And this one, I'm like, damn, I slept on this one. This is so pretty. I'm like, looking close up, really nice coverage, not weird at all. When I smile, it does not crack or anything, which is really nice. Hi there. Okay, cool. Let's try a different shade. Now, the last one I'm gonna try is this one. What is this one called? Dramatic Diva. This one is a straight up Barbie pink, and when I'm holding it up in the light, it has kind of like a gold reflex in there. It looks super pretty. Now, this doe foot is a lot longer than the Kylie and the ColourPop ones. I prefer this because it gets the whole mouth really quick. Okay, when the light hits this lip, I am living. This color is so gorgeous. I'm like, oh my god. Okay, this is like my 10th swatch and my mouth is like,
bitch, leave me alone.
So I am gonna leave it like that. I think it looks really pretty, really gorgeous. I'm like, okay, Dramatic Diva, I see you. I might have to order like 10 more of these before they're gone because this one is a keeper. All right, let's get our engines ready and let's pick the winner. So I just tried 3 brands, 3 different formulas, and all different shades. So who is gonna win? What is the drum roll? Ring! I really, really, really actually liked all of them. I know that's gonna probably shock all of you, but I think they all have their pros and cons. But the winner is Milani. Now, this formula is just A+. It glides on amazing. It is waterproof. It does not come off, which I love, because a lot of the Mattallics, like, they just come off after like 30 minutes and you have to reapply, or they get kind of patchy and weird, which is what I've noticed with a lot of brands. But these are unreal. Now, if these ones were a little more long wear, they would probably be up there, but they're not bad. I think the ColourPop one is amazing for $6. They are beautiful. Now, for $18, I do wish that these would be a little bit more metallic and a little bit more long wear, but it is all up to personal opinion. So, of course, as always, these are just my thoughts. We all have different experiences with makeup. I bought the Kylie and Milani ones out of my own pocket, and ColourPop graciously sends me PR to try their stuff. Now, just because people send me stuff doesn't mean I have to say I like it, or there's no secret contract behind hidden doors. It's just either I like it or I don't, and I love trying stuff out for you guys, and I do think that these are worth the money. So, at the end of the day, we're all gonna have different experiences with makeup. These are mine. Take it for what you want, and I hope that you guys try these and let me know your thoughts. If there are any more metallic lips that you want me to try, leave some brands in the comments down below, and I will see you guys on the next one. Mwah. Bye.